I saw the way she looked at me. With those desperate eyes, that hair, and her long and pretty fingers, I could have died there. I wasn't kidding when I looked at her and asked her to marry me. I knew she thought it was a joke, but I wasn't joking at all. Every relationship I had entered up until that point in my life had failed. Every last one. So why not just grab this one moment of perfection and wonderment and give it all and place a spontaneous bet? Maybe it would work and maybe it wouldn't, but goddammit, I was ready to know what it was like to fight and try. People were shocked when I mentioned love. I don't think they expected such idealism to come out of my mouth. And it's not that I never believed in love, it's that I believed in it too much. All I've ever wanted was to be inspired and motivated by a woman's lips. I wanted to feel challenged and exhilarated by her touch. I wanted to live inside her and trust her with every aspect of my life. To have her kick me in the ego when I got out of control and to hold me together when I fell apart. I wanted her to make me laugh and to know that I never wanted to be the villain. That was a result of where I came from, not who I was. It was what I was trained to do. It was all I had ever known. I wanted her to understand that I was brought up to be a criminal. And all I've ever wanted was for one woman to come along, brush me off, and say, "Yup, this one right here is perfect." But my past, my damages, and my impulses have always made it impossible for anyone to come close. And it's not that I didn't know how to love, it's that they didn't know how to love me. Last night, I smelled the alcohol on her breath. She kissed me like a bathroom hookup, sloppy with lots of spit. I wanted it more than anything. I wanted it, her, the moment, every inch of her skin, like a deep and aching thirst. I wanted to tear off her dress and take everything I wanted. I felt the urge to grab her by the hair, grit my teeth, and drive into her with the sound and fury of a Stooges record. And one day I would, but I didn't. Not there, not that night. And not even for her, but for me. Oh, she would be a story, but not like the rest. I would write her in gold. I would write about her the way the painter saw sunsets, and I would make her immortal. Because women like her on nights like that are perfect. They are ideal. Part of the handful of perfect minutes you get in a lifetime. Most people have never spoken my language. They would pretend to identify, and that wasn't what I needed. I didn't need sympathy. I needed passion, despite the past. I needed someone to touch me like they meant it for all the right reasons. And allowing me to share that sunrise was enough to let out a long and deep exhale. True exhale. One that said, "I'm right where I need to be at the right moment in time." The sun came up and she told me about her father, and I listened because it was all I could do for someone I couldn't fix. I held her hand, and I wanted to hold her so tightly that I could squeeze the pain from her fingertips. I wanted to wrap myself around her so nothing would or could ever hurt her heart. I wanted to tell her that if she could be exactly who she was in that moment forever, that I could give it all. Everything I had. I knew it would never be enough. She needed more than a slightly above average writer who shouted four-letter words all the time. We lived in different worlds, like being the C student in English class doing his best to keep the prom queen intrigued. I knew I couldn't, and I think she knew as well because she stopped, looked into my eyes, and said, "Just don't waste my time." So I lied and said, "I promise, pretty girl. I promise."